Order. Please continue.
I repeat again to the House that I have not seen any drafts of this report nor been briefed on its contents. But any speculation in advance of the release of the report by members opposite, in my view, would be uninformed, unwise and unfair.
Supplementary question. The Honourable Rick Barker.
Madam Speaker, to the Minister, are the opposition MPs correct when they claim that Deborah Houston was dismissed for being a whistleblower?
Madam Speaker.
The order! I cannot hear, therefore I cannot rule, while members continue with this chatter. Would the member, as I heard the question, it would appear that the minister has no ministerial responsibility for it, but would the member please repeat the question?
Madam Speaker, has the minister seen or heard of any reports from the Hawke's Bay District Health Board that the opposition MPs are claiming that Deborah Houston was dismissed for being a whistleblower?
That's right. The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, yes. I have seen a copy of the settlement document negotiated between the board and, between the Chief Executive and Ms Houston, which says inter alia, and I quote, "The Hawke's Bay District Health Board confirms and Ms Houston accepts that the restructuring that led to Ms Houston's position being disestablished was genuine and was unrelated to the protected disclosure."
Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Does he regard it as ethical that the Chief Executive was negotiating a contract which included the benefit of a trip around the world for himself?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, I cannot form a view on the ethics of a particular matter when the contents are not such in my possession.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Is the Minister aware that the CEOs of at least two other DHBs were intended to go on the same junket, and will he investigate what offers were made?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, it is my proposed course of action in the first instance to receive the Director General's Independent Governance Review report. If there are matters that either I or the Auditor General need to follow up pursuant to that, I shall be happy to do so.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Is the Minister aware that this information only came to light because of the whistleblower who did lose her job because of her integrity?
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, as I'm advised, there were some 50 jobs lost in the restructuring at Hawke's Bay, and as Ms Houston has herself signed this settlement document, which says she was not restructured because of the protected disclosure, it would appear that the member opposite is calling into question Ms Houston's integrity himself.
Supplementary question, Heather Roy.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. How many times did the Minister go to Hawke's Bay and meet with the Board to see for himself how dire the situation was, or call the Chair to Wellington for discussions? And if the answer is none, is that because he is taking all his information from his cronies, and it's much easier to persecute the sacked board from afar rather than go to Hawke's Bay, look them in the eye and hear the truth?
Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, in the first instance I took careful advice as to how I should properly handle a conflict situation in a district health board, and I followed that advice. And in the second place, if the member wishes to discuss cronyism, she may wish to raise it with Mr Tremaine and Mr Foss, who met regularly with Mr Atkinson.
Supplement. Order! Order! Point of order, Heather Roy.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I ask for your advice. I fail to see how the Minister addressed in any shape or form my question about how many times he met with the Board or called the Chair to Wellington over this situation.
No, I thought that he did actually address the question. Any further supplementaries? The Honourable Tony Ryall.
Will the Minister inquire as to when the study tour was first discussed? Was it before or after the tender offered to the, was it before or after tender documents were offered to Annette King's appointee, Mr Houseman?
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, my answer to the member's previous question stands.
No, would the Minister please clarify his answer?
Madam Speaker, that answer was that I shall await the report of the Director-General's Independent Governance Review Panel, and both I and the Auditor-General will then consider what further action is appropriate.
Thank you. Supplementary question, the Right Honourable Winston Peters.
Can I ask the Minister as to whether he's aware that Ms Houseman's settlement could be set aside if she was improperly coerced into signing it? Has she brought such an action, and if not, what does he make of her failure to do that in the light of claims by Mr Ryall?
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, I thank the member for his question. I'm aware of no attempt by Ms Houseman to seek any form of redress in respect of that settlement. Ms Houston, and I can only conclude that Mr Ryall is either misrepresenting or calling into question the integrity of Ms Houston.
Yeah. Any further... The Honourable Tony Ryall.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. This question to the Minister of Health. Did the Chief Executive Hawke's Bay District Health Board comply with both the District Health Board's procurement policies and public sector good practice when he awarded a $1.1 million contract to a subsidiary of Peter Houseman's Healthcare New Zealand without an open tender? If not, does he agree with Audit New Zealand's conclusions about this arrangement?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, I am advised that the WellCare contract in question was a joint contract between the Ministry of Social Development, Hawke's Bay DHB and WellCare, and that no DHB employee was known to be involved in the selection of WellCare as the service provider. However, I have no reason to doubt the Auditor-General's conclusion that procurement policies at Hawke's Bay District Health Board did not comply with good public sector practice. I also note that the Auditor-General will consider the results of the Director-General's review and any other further work being carried out on the AG's behalf before deciding whether or not further inquiry is warranted, an approach I commend to Mr Ryall.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Can the Minister confirm that Audit New Zealand's opinion is highly critical of the way that the Chief Executive handled this latest contract with Annette King's appointee, Mr Houseman, and says there was no evidence of formal conflict of interest procedures having been undertaken, the DHB's procurement policies were not followed, and there was no documented explanation of why there was no open tendering process?
Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, I can confirm that the Auditor-General's report is highly critical of a wide range of governance processes around the Hawke's Bay District Health Board, a matter which in the end the Minister has to hold the Board accountable for.
Supplementary question, Russell Fairbrother.
My supplementary to the Minister and asks, has the Hawke's Bay District Health Board prudently managed its resources and is this DHB adequately funded?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, I'm advised that the Hawke's Bay District Health Board funding has increased by over 100% since this government came to office, from $180 million to over $380 million. However, despite this increase, the Board was still unable to reach a break-even position and its deficit has recently seriously deteriorated. Madam Speaker, in this regard, I note that the Board was recently able to spend some $342,000 on legal expenses, a figure I'm assured would have bought for the people of Hawke's Bay some 21 hip replacements or 45 angioplasties.
Supplementary question, Chris Tremaine.
Can the Minister explain why Minister King's appointee, Mr Houseman, told the Hawke's Bay District Health Board in April 2006 that this $1.1 million contract had been implemented through a tender process which had been notified in the local press, when this was clearly not the case?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, without going back to the documents, I can no more explain that than I can why certain board members omitted to disclose on the board's register of pecuniary interests why they had shares in Royston Hospital or its parent.
Supplementary question. Craig Voss.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Supplementary to the Minister. Can the Minister explain why Mr Houseman started communicating with Hawke's Bay DHB staff on behalf of his company, Wellcare, in early August 2005, but only declared his interest in this company, Wellcare, to the DHB board in late February 2006, 7 months after his first dealings with staff?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, I am not prepared to look through the Director General's governance review process, and I imagine that that, along with a wide range of other evidence, is the subject of that review.
Supplementary question, Craig Voss.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Supplementary to the Minister. Is it acceptable for a DHB CEO to approve a $1.1 million contract with a board member's company without an open process, without reference to his board, as reported by Audit New Zealand, Auditor General, and is the Minister confident that this is not another case of something rotten with Labor?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, in the first place, it has nothing to do with the Labor Party, and in the second place,
order
would appear to be no more serious than the chairman of a district health board being involved in letting a contract to personal contacts and having that overruled by the Commerce Commission, or overwriting the minutes of an audit committee meeting after failing to tender a contract to Royston Hospital.
Supplementary question, Craig Voss.
A point of order, Madam Speaker.
A point of order, Craig Voss.
I seek leave to table the DHB board minutes where the CEO said that the Wellcare contract was put out to tender.
Leave is sought to table that document. Is there any objection? No objection. Question number... A point of order. Order the...